Oh my god, the plot thickens! Blood! Let's go! Let's go! You lot have been waiting for this one, innit? Because I know I've been waiting for this one. Yo, what's going on, everyone? It's your boy Sixpad back in the place, and I'm about to give you the first reaction to Shiro's Story Part 2. Now, Shiro's Story came out in April, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not going to ruin what happened. So if you haven't watched part one, it is down below in the description. So go ahead and check that out and then check this out. Part one was essentially about a guy and his friend and, you know, the one guy, Shiro, and the other friend, Kyle. Shiro was working at a supermarket, good boy, and he met a regular customer. The customer ended up getting him into the drug game. It did remind me a bit of Paid in Full. If any of you have watched Paid in Full. And then it turned out that Shiro helped his friend Kyle get into the game with him. You know, they were getting money together, everything was cool. And then Shiro said, you know what, I'm coming out of the game. I want to move my family somewhere. I'm going to go live another life. And Kyle was sad, but he was like, you know what, I'm happy to see my brother go. And I'm happy to see, well, I shouldn't really say brother. I'm happy to see my people go and, you know, go do their thing. But then we found out when Shiro was at a party with Kyle that Shiro's missus was in fact getting robbed by like a gunman, supposedly. So the phone rang and he was like, give me the code to the safe or I'm going to shoot your baby mum and your daughter. So he ended up giving them the code. When he gave them the code, he rushed home to find that his baby mum and his daughter had gone with the money, all the money. And to make it worse, Kyle was in fact with Shiro's baby mum. It's not even his baby mum. So what I just want to know is, what are you going to bring for me today, big man? Because you need to redeem yourself right now. Do you get me? Not even redeem yourself, because it's just a violation. You never knew, innit? However, he took your peas and he took his peas and he moved off with your family and went somewhere that you don't know. So right now, I think part two is probably going to pick up just after, or probably like straight after the events of number one. So I'm not going to waste no more time, guys. I'm just going to get straight into the review. Rapman's Shiro Story Part 2. Okay, so we got Kyle playing PS4. He's a waste man still. Could never have a friend like that.
Hey, Kiera, come here.
That was her name, Kiera. Shiro's baby mum's name was Kiera.
Come here.
She's not as good as what I remember.
What do you mean, what? Why is my controller sticky?
I don't know.
Why is my controller sticky?
Why is it going like a back, man?
If I have to ask you one more time, I swear to God, if I have to ask you one more time, why is my controller sticky?
I don't know, Kyla probably touched it.
What do you mean Kyla touched what? Kyla touched what? What did I tell you? What the fuck is that
game? Don't speak to me. Mommy!
Oh!
I want to tell you,
oh! So hold on, you mean to tell me, hold on. So somehow you got yourself wrapped up in this man, yeah? And now you mean to tell me you've went with him, Shiro treated you well, and you got mum boxing you in front of your daughter. You're not rated. So you're a dickhead already, Kiera. I don't like you. So why is he going like a bad man for? This is what I need to understand. Ross.
What did I tell you, huh? Touch my controller.
Don't hit the girl. Don't hit the door. 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 Don't hit the door.
I told you. I done told you, yeah? Don't touch my stuff. Stupid kid.
Over a controller, you know. It's like deep the argument over a controller. Anyway, back into the song.
Let me see, could the case be? Hey y'all, y'all remember Shiro? Download the money man, snake by his girl, and a friend he called his right hand. Things have been different from that day up in his crib. When he found out the daughter he's been raising wasn't his, would have never thought she was his best friend. The pain was so deep, he used to pray that it would end. Attempted suicide like a couple of times. Heartbroken so bad, he just figured it'd be better if he died. But God had a plan for him. He used to run it like nines and had one foot in. But then he quit his day job and he jumped in 2 feet deep. Now he's the biggest drug dealer in the southeast streets. But he had to make it up to the plug.
My nigga Shiro, you know. Alright then. Man said, fuck this bitch, I'm about to get my money. Alright, I rate it.
Before Carl left, he took food and didn't pay for the grub, yo. Way before he ate, he had to move extra weight. OT up in the trap to make sure that they were straight. But now he's even more kicked up than before. 100k racks, then we'll times that by four. And he's got a bag of youngers out working for him. Say the word and they're trigger fingers twerking for him. And he made them all know that whoever kills Carl gets 20k cash, no harm, no foul.
Listen, I'm gassed already. Man said, I've got a hit out on the nigga, 20 bags, and it. Oi! Shiro! My guy, let's go.
He still loves them both, he just won't say it loud. He knows that he's supposed to hate her. And for the first couple months he did. But it's been like a year, hasn't seen, doesn't hear, kinda peak. Don't even know how Kyla is. He just sees it as he told Carl all of his business. And he used what he knew just to get her in bed. Say he doubled up the score and had to come 20 more. 21 who finds Carl will make sure that he's dead. Money getting doubled, all the youngers getting mad. Trying to get the drop on Carl, hoping they secure the bag. Old yards, old links, all the spots that used to jam. But everybody that the yard says they haven't seen.
Okay, alright.
Where the fuck is
Carl?
You know what? Furthermore, bust your gun if you're gonna bust your gun,
Ruben.
I told you, man, not to wear
Kylie's, innit?
What?
Cold as a crud! Oh my god! Man said, shoot then. Nah. Oi, look, he's on crud.
Fucking mad, hey,
no point in killing these bums for free, boss.
I listen to your brethren, man. Pussy boys.
You know you're dealing with me, man.
I listen, hey, man. I see your big brother, man's gonna fuck him up anyway. Rich.
Young Abdi,
shave that quiff off your head, you little pussy, yo. Are you calling, man? The phone and Kyle, you got my eye moving loose.
Hey
Kyle!
He's a ghost. On Instagram it's been a year since he posted. Shiro's getting tired too, he's been doing the most. Thinking this is long and he's about to let it go. But then he sees a private...
So a private number has just rang Shiro's phone. I'm thinking it might be the daughter. I'm not too sure.
But he don't say a word. Yet then one's there, you wait for them to speak first. But no one don't talk, so he's about to let it drop. But then he hears a voice and then he makes his heart stop.
Shiro, it's me, it's Kiera. I'm so sorry, I've done you so wrong. I know you must have like a million questions. I'll answer what I can, but I can't stay too long. This last year has been the worst of my life. And leaving you was my biggest mistake. God.
You're damn right.
It's me, Shiro, he hits me. I'm scared Kyla's gonna meet the same fate. So what, you don't have the same blood? You're the only man she's ever called dad. If we stay here, I know we're gonna die. Shiro, please, can you just take us back?
Shiro can't believe that he's been hitting her. He told her he's been missing her, and yeah, take her back. But Carl's gotta pay, and the only real way is if he lands him up.
Okay. My only problem with this now is she's done this to you, and you wanna take her back. I don't know about all of that, big man. I don't know about all of that, big man. It's never been that still. It's never been to come back still. It's never been that.
The dying gets every
single rap. She agreed. Now Sharon knew exactly where he'd be. Next day he's at a rave, so he told his young G's. The very next night, Carl was leaving the club. Busy chatting to a chick, he didn't see them pulling up. The youngest started firing and letting off. Carly started getting off. He got around, they plan, they stopping out to his head is off. Sharon told them, dead him off. No matter what, just get it off. He's trying to get, but they're trying to hit, cause that's still we gave, they pull it off. But Carly got away. The youngest tried hitting, but instead they hit a straight. And Shari was pissed, not only cause they missed, but them youngest got nicked. Now he's worried that they're snitched.
What to do now?
He ain't trying to go to jail. Figured that he's gotta leave. Till the case is done, he's packing up and moving overseas. Kiera kinda coming too. Now Carl will be the fool. Speaking every day since she called, so he knows it's true. He ain't spoke to Kyla though, just in case she lets it slip. Kyle still don't know who it was to try to get him pitched. Shari's gonna finish it, but right now he's gotta go. Kiera says she's ready, got the parcel, said she's got his door. So Shiro made his way. It didn't take long, was only 20 miles away. He sent a little text to let her know that he arrived. She said she needs some help with the bags, come inside. He steps inside the house.
Alright, listen. I'm not ready. Why? Look, she set you up, you dickhead. Oh my god. Oh! Here's my problem. Why are you going into the house? Why are you doing it? Why are you going into the house? You don't need to. What? You don't need to go into the house. Like, nah, man. I'm not on it for Shiro to get punched up or killed. Nah, man. I'm not on this. I'm not on it. Fuck this, man.
He can't believe his eyes. Carl standing there with.
Nah, man. What the fuck, man? Oh my god. And he's smiling like the fucking Grinch, bro. Like what? Nah, man, I'm pissed. I'm actually pissed.
Gunny said surprise, smile on his face while he stares him in his eyes. Carl told him straight, coming here wasn't wise.
You're fucked now.
Kiera for the
pain.
I said I'm so sorry, but he forced me to lie. I said that
you see this girl? You see this girl? She's a dread. I was gonna say something about a brown skin girl, but yo. I'm joking, innit? Nah!
I didn't mean Kyla was dying. Shiro screamed to Carl, fam, just tell me why. Carl said, look, I wasn't after your life, but you said the young Jesus, that's a guy for an eye. Shiro said, nah, I'm talking way before that. You already took my life, everything I ever had. Fam, I gave you anything, I never asked for nothing back. I thought you was my brother, how you do me like that? You weren't even like that. She moved to me and that's a fact. Them times she was
your
life, I never fought your wife.
Hold it! Oh my god, the plot thickens! Blood! Let's go! She's a hoe! She is a hoe! Oh my god!
But then she got pregnant, you was got to have a kid. So I decided not to ruin that by saying that I hit. Find out that she was mine, but I still let it be. Cause I ain't trying to have for you, I'm just trying to get the pee. And then you got the plug, and you could've put me in, but you just took me for a month.
You what?
Yeah, you put me on, but only after you was up. We could've worked in together, but you either play boss and be the one with all the cheddar. So when Kiera started hitting me up, I saw an opportunity to get my money up. I only wanted the stacks, she ain't even with that. And after Kyla, it get.
A man said she ain't even heard that. A man said, yeah, that dish, she's just a thing, bro.
Dad needs a slap. Shiro, he just snaps. He spares into cars so hard, he dropped his strap.
Go on.
Chops the punch, he wants to feel that face crack.
Go on.
Carl getting battered, man, his skin will turn black.
Bruh.
Kiera gets the gun and tells Shiro, get him back. Shiro's getting mad. He doesn't understand. He steps away from Carl and he just...
If this girl shoots him, oh my god.
He closes his eyes and we hear this thing back. Kiera shot Carl on his shoulder in his hand.
You finally done something right. Thank you, Kiera. Blood. Punch him up, blood. Punch him up, blood.
Yes, you bitch!
No, dead all that. Carl, where's my money? Ain't got any. Brother, you deaf. You got two choices, you know. Tell me where my money is, I will end you.
Listen, I ain't got any.
I ain't got any. And Charlotte can spin it all.
You did not spend that. You did not spend that much money in a year. No way. No way. I don't believe you. Sorry.
It's upstairs. It's upstairs.
Upstairs where?
Under my bed.
Kira, go check upstairs under the bed.
Don't lie to me again, Colin.
Kira! Is it there?
There's clothes. I don't know how much.
Well, you never had no money, Carl. You lied to me again, Carl. You don't feel me. Where's enough food? Where's enough food? It's in the kitchen. Check in the kitchen, Kira. Can you see the food?
Yeah, there's clothes.
Just leave me 10 bags. Leave me 10 bags.
Marcella! Listen! A man said, 10 bags. Fuck all that, blood. Are you mad? Are you mad? Listen. Oh, oi. Leave me 10 bags. Fuck that, big man. Fuck all that. I'm looking to.
You know what? I'm gonna leave you more than 10 bucks. I'm gonna leave you your fucking life. Pussy.
Shower told her straight, look, I'll finish you off. Unless you give up all your cash, everything that you got. Carl gives it up, 150k suck. They leave with the bag, left the bleeding abrupt. He told her calm down, she was still shaking up. She told him that she saw he never meant to set him up. He overheard the call and put the gun to my gut. Said to tell him what I know, or he's gonna shoot me up. And Kylie, yeah, she stood at her friends. But he said they go down and put her life to an end. I was sick of all the fear, always had him in my head. So I told you, get back.
Shiro, don't take this girl back, you know. You get me? Don't take her back. Look. This is where you were. This is where you are. You're here now, you get me? You were here. You were off camera. For, like, at the start of this. Get me? You're now here. Stay there. You take her back. You're plummeting back down, big man. Don't take her back. Take your daughter. Take your peas. And go live somewhere else.
I could just shoot him dead. But please don't believe what he said. It was always him trying to get me into bed. And I swear I regret it every day. So just tell me now, should I come or should I stay? Shower thinks about it for a bit, then replies with a hug and follows up with a kiss. He said he loves her no matter what people think. He don't care about Carl, let's just go and get our kid. That very same night they grab Kyla from her friends. A dream come true, they're all a family again. Next morning in the car, finally about to leave. A brand new start, a new life overseas. About to drive off on the way to the airport. Kira says to quickly double check you got the passports. Shower does a search, oh shit, you was right. I left Kyla's passport on the table near the light. It's okay, babe, don't stress, I'll go get it. Kira saw the purple exactly where he said it. She opened it up, a piece of paper dropped out. Yo, Kira, I really hope you get this. I wrote this letter just to tell you how I feel. I missed you every day that you was gone. So now I have you back, it just seems so surreal. And last night.
Alright, listen. If he's left her, I rate him.
You made love for the first time in nearly a year. Then afterwards you pulled me close and you told me that you loved me when you whispered in my ear. It was that point there that I clocked. I had you right there, exactly where I want. You dumb little bitch, you really thought I forgot that you slept with my friend and you gave him my guap.
Yeah.
I just used you to help get my pee back and catch Carl because that pricky had to bleed. But mainly for you to bring Kyla because that's my little girl and yeah, she belongs with me. I give a fuck about that DNA shit. But the maddest thing about this letter is the further that you read down the page, the closer that we get to the airport. So if you're reading this now, you're already too late. Goodbye.
Let's go!
You're done enough.
See what happens when you're a dickhead. See what happens when you're a dickhead, yeah?
Shiro!
Wait, chill. Wait, who took Manny's where?
Shiro, he's fucking taken her. He's taken her somewhere. I think he's gone to the fucking airport.
What do you mean, Shiro? The fucking, I thought Carl was the fucking dad about Shiro.
Yeah, he is the dad.
Hey, listen, you remember moving mad, listen. He ain't been condoning your behaviour, you know. Let alone with them two fucking niggas. You know I don't fucking like.
You can't get her back. I don't know, please. You gotta help me. I don't know what he's doing.
Cadet is a mad... Oi, Cadet is in this as well. Damn, is it mad? The casting of this is so sick.
My family is a different fucking thing. My niece is a different fucking thing. Alright, hey man, let me sort this out, because you're even fucking mad.
You know how I handle violations.
Are you mad?
Will you though? Will you actually...
Of course, it's honour. I'm going to phone you back.
Okay, rah, that's a mad thing. The part three is gonna be mad. Hey, listen, Cadet, yeah, Cadet is gonna kill him. Oh, Rapman, all I've gotta say is, yeah, you have done with this story and this little thing here that you got there. Like, I feel like you're gonna start a trend. I feel like people are gonna do like stories and parts and continuations of like stuff like that, like this. And I feel like it's good because look what it brings out, man. I'm mad blood, do you get me? Like, but I'm not mad now, but I was mad blood when like Kyle was saying that, like hitting her and then saying like, I'll hit you to the baby and that, you're mad. What? Hold on, this is my thing. Why the fuck did you call your brother when he was punching you up, blood? Are you a dickhead? What? So hold on, you mean to tell me you was with him for a year? It's Kyle, you, yeah. He was hitting you, he was punching you up. He claimed to say, I'm gonna put a gun to your chest and shoot you, but you didn't think to ring your brother if your brother's a bad man like this. Sense. That's my only thing. Secondly, Shiro, you're a G for taking the U. I hope you get away. I hope Cadet doesn't get his grubby mitts on you. Yeah, because if he does, you're a dead man. And it's just that's just a fact, isn't it? Kyle, I hope you bled out, you prick. Kiera, I hope your brother even this is my prediction for part three. I think personally, Shiro's gonna get away with the U. Kyle's gonna get murdered by the brother and the what's the Dottie slag's name? Kiera. Her name. Her. She's gonna get X'd up. Nah, she's not gonna get X'd up. I feel like she's just gonna get her comeuppance, and it, like, her comeuppance is, you're not with your daughter anymore. You get me? Guys. It's been amazing the past couple of days. First two videos done really well in like numbers wise, likes wise. So if we could try to smash the like button on this one as well. You know, like, share, subscribe. As I said, more content coming really soon. But share this around, man. Tag, if you're gonna share it, tag Rapman in it so he can see it somehow. So hopefully we get enough views and he sees it and, you know, something like that happens. But yeah, what I really want people to do as well is in the comments, yeah, I want you to type what you think about this and what you think is going to happen in part three. So if you could just leave a little comment there. As I said, I think Shiro's going to get away personally. I think Kyle's going to die. I think the brother's going to kill Kyle. And I think the Kiera girl is going to get her comeuppance in it, and she's not going to be with her daughter anymore. That's literally it from me, guys. So thanks anyway, but I'll see you in the next one. This has been Sixpad, and thank you for being on my channel. Remember to like, share, subscribe, all that jazz. Social media is in the bottom. Part one is in the bottom in the description. And yeah, here's to part three, and I'll see you in the next one. And I'm out.